get ready to learn about TransZoom 3. This plugin contains a few different categories and they share similar controls. We'll start with this category using this preset. The first control we'll go over is Edit Mode. To activate it, click on this box. Notice the change in the viewer. Let's check out the playback. With Edit Mode on, we can see changes to our transition as we make adjustments. We can also see our color channel values. Transition A shows the end frame of the first clip. Below it, we can see our A zoom amount as indicated by this slider and value. On the right side, we can see the beginning frame of the second clip and the zoom amount for it. On the bottom left, we'll see a grid showing how distorted our clips are during the transition. In the bottom center, we'll see how much our clips spin during the transition. And on the bottom right, we'll see a graph showing the animation curve. Now, we'll deselect it. Underneath that, we have the motion blur controls. We'll turn it on by clicking on the box. Next, let's check out motion blur amount. The motion blur amount controls how much blur there is during the transition. Here's how that looks. Below that, we have animation type. In this menu, we can select a style of animation. We'll choose swing. Here's the result. We recommend playing around with the different animation types. Now let's check out the transition controls, starting with A zoom amount. A zoom amount adjusts how much the first clip zooms in during the transition. Let's check it out. And below that, let's check out B zoom amount. B zoom amount controls how much the second clip zooms in during the transition. Let's check out the playback. Next, let's check out spin. In this menu, we can select the direction and number of cycles that we want the transition to rotate. We'll choose clockwise 3 times. Here's the result. This is a great control to play around with. These next 3 controls will add a shake effect to the transition. Shake amount determines how far out the clips will shake. Shake frequency adjusts how much the clip shakes. And shake noisiness increases the number of shakes that will occur during the effect. Let's check out the results. Next, let's check out style controls. In the Shear Direction menu, we can choose a vertical or horizontal orientation, as well as the direction for the shear. We'll choose horizontal clockwise. Next, we have Shear Amount. Shear Amount determines the intensity of the shear effect. Let's check out the playback. Below that, we have Flash Amount. Flash Amount adds a brightening effect during the transition. Let's see how that works. Are you feeling it? And at the bottom, we can distort the color controls, starting with red. First, the red channel control adjusts how much distortion will occur in the red values. The green channel control adjusts the amount of distortion in the green values. And the blue channel control determines how much distortion occurs in the blue values. Let's see a comparison. It's a pretty subtle difference. Now that we've seen all this preset has to offer, let's move on to the next one. And we've already seen these controls, so we'll skip to the unique ones, starting with these three bulge controls. Bulge animation determines which direction the effect will travel during the transition. From this menu, we'll choose backward. Bulge radius adjusts the size of the bulge during the animation. And bulge amount controls the intensity of the effect. Let's see how that compares. With all these controls, we can create amazing bulge effects in our transition. Next, we'll see our twirl controls. Twirl radius determines the size of the twirl effect. And twirl amount controls the intensity of the effect. Now let's check it out. Such a fun effect. Now that you're familiar with all these controls, we can't wait to see how you use this plugin.